business.
No, I suppose it isn't. You know, I'm sure there was a reason you were acting the way you have been for the past few weeks, but I never imagined that it was that.
That? What's that?
That?
You're just so surprised that I found a man who appreciates me the way that I have wanted to be appreciated, something you could never do?
I know that you've been lonely ever since we stopped seeing one another. I just didn't think that you would pick up with a... Come on, Lila, he's just a kid.
Oh, I feel infinitely better after taking that shower. You really should try one, Harriet. What are you looking at?
Oh, that big black castle out there in the middle of the city.
Mm-hmm.
What do you suppose that is?
Well, that's Edinburgh Castle. The mountain it sits on is made all of volcanic rock. You can see it from everywhere.
Oh, it gives me the creeps.
Oh.
That reminds me of Duncan's castle and all the scary things that ever happened to us there. How many times have you been here, anyway?
Oh, just a few. I flew up here for a weekend party one time with Uncle Earl, and then last year that we were together... Matter of fact, he was either here or in Ireland the whole time.
Oh. Shannon?
Yeah?
Don't you think you ought to let somebody back home know that we're all right?
I will, eventually.
Well, I really would like to call Beatrice, if you don't mind.
No, just as long as you don't tell her that we're in Edinburgh.
Well, is that really necessary?
Yes, it's really, really necessary.
Okay, won't tell. It'd be hard enough talking to her anyway, feeling that I've betrayed her utterly.
Oh, Harriet, you didn't tell me that she and Brian were in love. I knew already. Soon, both she and Brian will realize that I did the very best thing by calling the wedding off at the last minute.
What are you doing in here? Answer me!
I'm looking for something that your brother stole from me.
You must be mad. My brother would never take anything that didn't belong to him.
Really? Really? Oh, my dear Miss McKechnie, there's so many things about your brother that you don't know. For instance, all those years that he had you safely shipped off to convent schools throughout Europe, you don't know about his activities.
How would you know so much about Duncan?
I worked for Taggart for years. Believe me, there's a lot of things about your brother I don't think you want to hear.
I think you'd better leave. I'll call the police.
Why? You don't want to call the police, and there's no reason to be frightened of me. See, I'm just curious about this note.
This was for me. You had no right to read it.
I'm sorry that I did read it, but I'm just curious about Duncan and why he's so interested in Thomas. And what Thomas might have said about Suzanne and me.
You've got to promise me something. You must promise me that you won't tell anybody that you think you saw Stenbeck strangling Suzanne. It could put you in extreme danger.
You're frightening me, Duncan.
I'm telling you this so you'll be careful.
Miss McKechnie, I ask you a question.
Brought to you today by Bold 3, for clothes that feel as good as they look, and by Secret. Now Secret has a putter fresh scent with the same strong pH balanced formula to help keep a woman dry.
Why are you afraid of me? All I want to do is talk to you.
Whatever you want to know, you can ask my brother. I don't know anything.
Oh, I think you do. I think you know a lot.
Stay away from me.
You can trust me. Just protect me. Don't be afraid of me because I work for Taggart. I swear to you, I didn't know anything about his covert activities until just a few months ago. Just like you don't know anything about your brother's covert
activities. Stop it! I don't want to hear another word against my brother. Especially from the likes of you.
Why did he leave suddenly?
What's he doing in Edinburgh?
He was called away on business.
Called away on business? Business? Business. Yes, he does a lot in the name of business. Why is he so interested in Thomas and Suzanne? Why in such a rush? Now, Thomas and Suzanne were both killed by Hensley Taggart because he knew too much. Don't try to leave. You and I aren't finished yet. I'd advise you to keep this little visit of ours a secret for your dear brother Duncan's sake.
Goodness, you're here.
I was just came to see your
funeral. James Stenbeck.
What are you telling me?
He was here.
Where is he now?
He went out through the secret passageway.
Looking for Beatrice.
He said he was looking for something my brother had stolen from him.
I still blame myself for everything that's happened. I wish with all my heart Beatrice hadn't told me how she felt.
Harry, will you listen to me? I am taking care of myself. No woman should marry any man, no matter how much she loves him, knowing that he loves another woman.
Brian denied that.
Of course he denied it because he's not aware of it himself. And he can't admit it or accept it while I'm there. That's why we're here. And believe me, Beatrice is exactly the kind of woman he needs.
You're wrong, Shannon.
Oh, Harry, you're just saying that because you are trying to soothe me and you care about me and you think I'm going to go off the deep end. Don't you feel that way? I will be fine. And now you have to take a shower so that we can go dining and then we can go see the McKechnie Manor and find out what secrets Duncan has hidden away on this side of the Atlantic.
And so you're saying to me that Margot approves, huh?
Yes, I'm saying that because she loves me and she's concerned about me. She wants me to be happy, and that's exactly what I am, happy.
And Craig, does Craig know?
Yes, and he knows.
Oh, yeah. I can tell by the way you answered the question, the look on your face, that he doesn't really approve, does he?
It's just that it's been a bit of a shock for me.
I think it's a bit of a shock to everyone.
John, can't you understand? Casey makes me happy.
You know, in the midst of all this happiness, do you ever stop to think that you have kids living in this house while the two of you are carrying on? There are youngsters
living on. I'm not carrying on.
Well, I'm not altogether sure I want Dusty living in a house with
you. And I'm not altogether sure why Dusty's even living with me. Why don't you just get out, okay?
Lila, I'm concerned about you. I care about you. Can I give you some advice?
I don't want your advice. I don't want your opinion, okay? And I just would appreciate it. You just don't mention this to anybody at the hospital, will you please do that?
Why did you think about what you just said? You feeling just a little bit of guilt, huh? A little bit?
What do you think of Joe Bailey's offer?
Well, I think it's a great opportunity as well as an honor. What about your new job as DA?
Well, he just wants me to set it up, not run it. Give me your coat.
Oh, yeah. Wouldn't that mean going to Washington?
Yeah, I'd have to be gone for a few months, but I just assigned somebody as temporary DA.
Oh, good.
I tell you, that meeting at the state capitol, the crime commission, really whet my appetite.
What does Margot have to say about all this?
Well, I haven't discussed it with her yet, but our marriage has lasted through some career separations before. It's not the worst thing that can happen to a marriage. Yeah.
You want some coffee?
Yeah, please.
You're probably wondering why I came. Lisa and Earl aren't planning to live in my dad's house, and since I don't much fancy the idea of living there by myself, I was thinking about turning it into a rehab center. Halfway house for young people. What do you think?
I think that's a great idea, and I also think Franny might like to help you out with that when she gets back.
Yeah. I haven't talked to Lisa about it, but I'm sure she won't object. When I started writing all these editorials about the Falcon, I got to meet some of the kids who were victims of drug abuse. I'd really love for them to have a place where they could land back on their feet, you know, proper counseling and all that. Let me get to work on it, okay?
Good. I want some lunch.
Hey, I'm starved.
Yeah, me too.
You got
it. I don't know. Let's find out. One for you.
Oh, thank you. Pretty good.
Brian.
Yeah.
Can you hear from Shannon?
No. No. You're probably wondering why she called the wedding off.
Yeah, but if you don't want to talk about it...
No, it's probably do me good to get it off my chest. Shannon thinks I'm in love with Beatrice McKechnie. Not only that, but she thinks that Beatrice McKechnie is in love with me.
Now, where did she get a crazy idea like that?
I have no idea.
It is a crazy idea, man.
Well, of course it's a crazy idea. I'm sure there was a little transference when she came to terms with the fact that Thomas Beaton was dead.
So where are all your feelings involved in all this?
Well, Beatrice is a friend.
Brian is your friend and twice best man. Maybe you should think about what it was that made Shannon come to that conclusion.
Oh, my darling. I just wonder what all of those ladies would say. You know, all those women you were so busy romancing and you were working undercover, as you put it. I wonder what they'd say when they found out that I made an honest man of you.
Well, they probably wouldn't believe it.
You sure you can give up all that glamorous, exciting life for little old me, huh?
Oh, I have already. And besides, isn't it very hard work and it's very dangerous? What do you mean, glamorous?
Oh.
It wears very thin on your nerves after a while. From now on, I am going to take it easy.
Well, so have you given any thought to that job offer that Brian gave his artist?
I think I'm going to take Brian up on it. I want to discuss it with him when he's in better spirits.
Oh, Lord knows when that'll be. Maybe Shannon will come to her senses, though, and come back home and straighten this whole mess out.
Well, something tells me that is not going to happen. As Shannon's uncle, I thought I knew her better than anybody, but this time she's even surprised me.
Oh, where do you think she is?
Who knows? I showed her the world. She could be anywhere in it. Listen, this whole thing gets settled. I am going to take you on the longest honeymoon, and I am going to show you the world.
Oh, darling, I just feel like these last few days have... This has been a honeymoon, you know. No, don't you dare get that. I'm going to get this phone. It's probably one of your old flames. I'm going to let them know you're not available. Hello, this is the Mitchell residence. This is Mrs. Mitchell speaking.
Lisa, it's Shannon.
Shannon? Oh, Shannon, darling. Oh, we've been... Where are you? We're just worried sick about you. Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine, honestly. But I'd really rather keep my whereabouts a secret for now.
Is Harriet there with you?
Yes.
Oh, Shannon, please, darling, please come back from wherever you are and settle this whole mess, please. Wait a minute. Your uncle wants to talk to you.
Shannon, are you all right? I am very confused, young lady.
Please don't be. I only did what I thought was right. Isn't it ironic how you're the one to settle down instead of me? I'm so glad for you that you found somebody who can make you happy.
I would be a lot happier if you would come back home and straighten out this whole mess.
Uncle Earl, you know better. I am home. Your little bird is out in the world where she belongs.
Shannon, can't you see what you're doing? You're running away from life again.
No, Uncle Earl, I'm running to life. Listen, I'm sorry. I have to go. I just wanted to touch base. And I would like it if you would tell Brian that I'm okay and not to worry. And to think very hard about why I did this. Listen, I love you and Lisa very much, and I wish you all the happiness in the world.
But Shannon,
Bye.
She hung up.
What?
Oh, she's as stubborn as she is unpredictable.
Oh, darling. Look, maybe she'll get her act together and come around to take care of all of this. In the meantime, we've got to find Brian and just let him know that Shannon is all right.
Well, I'm not convinced that she's all right. Not for a second.
Oh, you're right, Shannon. I feel much better after that shower.
Good.
Who were you talking to on the phone just now?
Oh, Lisa and Earl. I wanted them to pass along to Brian that I am okay.
Well, I'm sure Brian would much rather hear it from you.
Harriet, I can't do that. I told you. I want to have a clean break with no bad goodbyes.
Now, let's go. Let's get over to Duncan's before it gets too dark. I don't understand. I thought that the castle that Duncan put up in Oakvale was his ancestral home.
No. That was his great, 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 great
Grandfather Angus's castle by the sea. This is the place where Angus's descendants have lived ever since they've been civilized.
You can call Duncan civilized, that is. Sometimes I'm not too sure.
Why are you so anxious to go there?
Curiosity. I was married to the man for 8 years, after all. Besides, he's always been so mysterious. I never asked him who lives there and what it's like. Mm-hmm. And besides, we don't know anybody else in Edinburgh. What else are we going to do?
I don't know about this, Shannon.
Oh, Harriet, where is your spirit of adventure?
Of adventure? Well, it's pretty much exhausted since I got to know you.
Oh, pish. It'll be fun. Oh, I'll call first if that'll make you feel better.
And say what?
I don't know. I'll figure that out when I get on the phone.
What exactly is it that you think you're going to find there?
I don't know. But I do know that we won't have Duncan there to interfere, so we'll have the element of surprise on our side.
Excuse me, miss. How much longer before we reach Heathrow?
Oh, about 2 hours. Don't worry, you'll make your connecting flight to Edinburgh.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Duncan, you weren't involved in what Hensley was doing, were you?
No, Beatrice, of course not. How could you think such a thing of me?
Because of Thomas. And even Suzanne.
Suzanne?
I asked Thomas once about her, and he swore to me there was nothing between them. But he said she came to him for help. That she was involved with another man, and she was afraid of you finding out. She said she already knew too much. She was afraid of making you angry.
I'd appreciate it if you wouldn't mention this to anybody at the hospital. Now, will you please leave?
Ah, will you think about what you just said? You must be feeling quite a bit of guilt, huh?
Hello?
Well, hello, gorgeous. How you doing?
Okay.
Hey, by the way, did you get any deliveries today?
Yeah, the roses are beautiful, thank you.
Well, I got to work, and I couldn't stop thinking about you, so I thought maybe they might cheer you up.
Well, that was very thoughtful of you.
Lila, if there's something wrong, you sound kind of funny.
Have you talked to John yet today?
No, why?
Dr. Peretti, I see you. Dr. Peretti,
listen,
I see you.
I'm being paged. I gotta go. I'll call you back first chance I get, okay?
Casey, wait. Casey?
Hi, Mama. Are you busy?
I was trying to call you.
Well, yeah, I've been out on the case and stuff. I just really wanted to come by quickly to see how you were doing.
ooh, look at these beautiful flowers. I guess I don't have to ask who sent them to you. Mm-hmm. Oh, by the way, Craig came by to see me today.
Yeah, I thought he might.
Oh, Mama. Give him time, Mama. He'll come around.
Yeah, Craig might. I don't know about John, though.
John? John knows?
I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just really scared. Maybe they're right.
Wait a minute.
Maybe...
Wait a minute. You listen to me. You just listen to me for a minute. Casey Peretti is the first man who has made you happy in a long, long time. So don't you let anybody tell you that it's wrong. Because if anyone is as deserving as happiness as you are, it can't be wrong. Do you hear me?
Thank you for the pep talk.
Is it sinking in?
I just need some time to think about it.
Don't sit around thinking about your feelings, and don't sit around thinking about what everyone else thinks. Just be happy, okay?
Marco, it's not that simple.
Yes, it is that simple. It may not seem that simple, but you've got the best shot of happiness of all of us combined. I gotta go, all right. I'll call back later and I'll check in on you and make sure that you're okay.
It's okay.
Next time I see you, I wanna see a smile on that punim. My best to Casey, will you?
thing that Margot showed up when she did.
Well, I probably overreacted.
Beatrice, don't take any chances, all right? I really wish that you'd think about moving to the mainland, someplace where you'd be safe.
I'll be fine. I talked to George. He's going to keep the dogs loose at all times. And I doubt Mr. Stenbeck will be back again anyway.
All right. But if he tries to contact you again, I want you to get a hold of me, day or night. Promise me that.
Brian, I don't want to be a burden to you.
When are you going to understand that you couldn't possibly ever become a burden to me?
Brian, I'm very sorry about the wedding. You know, Shannon always has been a flake.
John, you know, I really would appreciate it if you could keep your opinions to yourself.
Excuse me, I've got to see Dr. Mike.
I'll walk you there. Goodbye, John. Come on.
Oh, John. Got something for you. Buy half of the $5,000 you gave Lance.
What about that other promise, huh?
Well, actually, you know, there's been a very interesting development on that front.
Really?
Tell me all about it. Well, not yet.
But I tell you, I think you're right about Stenbeck being involved in something really heavy.
Oh, I'm sure I am. I read the papers, you know. This Falcon business, I think he's into that.
He's not as innocent as he says. As a matter of fact, I wouldn't be a bit surprised if he was the Falcon himself. I just wish I had a way to prove it.
Oh, hello, Paul. Oh, Paul, I'm glad I caught you at home. Son, I am very sorry. We're going to have to cancel our trip to Chicago. No. It had nothing to do with your mother. It's work. I'm behind here at the office, but I promise you I'm going to make it up to you, okay? I love you too, son.
Excuse me, Mr. Stenbeck. There's a Detective Hughes outside. She insists on seeing you.
Oh, yes, of course. Send her right on in.
I'm already in.
It's all right, Lauren. You can leave us alone and make sure that we're not disturbed, okay? Yes. Well, Margot, what can I do for you?
I think you already know. I understand I interrupted a little visit you were paying out to McKechnie Castle. What were you doing in Duncan McKechnie's bedchamber scaring the living daylights out of his sister?
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you today by Cascade. Both regular and lemon scent Cascade leave your dishes virtually spotless. And by Downy, the fabric softener that combines skin-loving softness with the airy April freshness you love. We'll continue with part two of As the World Turns in just a moment. And now, part two of As the World Turns.
Well, I must say, Margot, from the time you were my stable hand, you've come a long way. You fit this policewoman's role real good.
I just came here for an explanation, James.
Fine. I was at the castle the night of the wedding. It's the first time I've been back since the night I saved your life. And I remembered that Hensley told me about secret places in the castle where Duncan kept certain things.
Like what?
I don't know. Hensley never told me. But I was just playing a hunch that someone had moved those secret ledgers that I stumbled upon, the ones that alerted me to Hensley's covert action, to one of those secret places, that's all.
Someone meaning Duncan?
Margot, I'm not accusing anyone of anything. Duncan says that these ledgers never existed. They disappeared after Hensley's death. The police only have my word that they did exist. I'm just doing a little detective work, that's it.
Send me something. Does this look like it could have been a page out of one of those ledgers?
Where did you get this?
Never mind. Does it mean anything to you, the address circled? Or any of the other addresses for that matter?
No, I do know that both Hensley and Duncan went to Toronto and Chicago. That's all. Does that help?
Good. Thank you very much for your time.
So I guess until this case is closed, I'll still be under suspicion, correct?
That's privileged information, and you're not privileged. If I find that you've been out on the island again without permission, I'll have you arrested.
Margot, you know me well enough to know that I never make the same mistake twice.
Wrong. I don't know you well at all.
I found out that the charges against me brought by your dear father will be in February. Tom will be the DA by then, right?
Yes, why?
I just hope that I'm not dealing with a court that's predisposed to hang me. That's all.
You'll have a fair trial, just like everybody else would. Keep yourself available. I'll be in touch.
All right, Julia. Yes. Tell Beatrice that I called and that I'm really sorry to have missed her. No. There's no number at which I can be reached. I'll keep in touch with you. Okay. Goodbye.
Beatrice out?
Yeah.
Miss Brian?
Yeah.
Well, are you all ready for dining and a tour of the McKechnie Manor?
I suppose so. But do me a favor. Call first.
Why, first? Because I put that back. Let me know.
McKechnie residence.
Hello. Is this the housekeeper?
Yes.
Hello. My name is Shannon O'Hara. I'm a very good friend of Duncan McKechnie's, and he told me that whenever I was here on holiday in Edinburgh, which I am now, with a friend of mine, that we could come over to the ancestral home for a little tour. Hello? Are you still there?
I'm sorry. No one is allowed to visit without Mr. McKechnie's permission.
Oh, I know, but he's... I don't believe that.
What?
He hung up on me. He made it very clear that we weren't welcome.
Good. Then I can relax and enjoy my dinner.
Oh, no, my dear, we're still going.
But Shannon...
Harriet, I'm not going to let a silly hang-up stop me. Worst that housekeeper can do is slam the door in our face, right?
How do you know that? If Duncan has man-eating fish and vicious dogs in Oakdale, who's to say what's keeping house for him here?
Okay, make sure she gets no more than this dosage. I don't care how much she says she can't sleep, okay?
Yes, doctor.
That's it.
Do you have time for a cup of coffee?
Well, I don't right now. Maybe some other time, though, okay?
Hope so.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Casey, you got a minute to talk?
No, I'm really kind of in a hurry right now, John.
Why don't you make some time, okay?
What's the matter?
You and Lila. I was over at her place when your flowers arrived today.
You got a problem with that?
I hope I don't.
Well, I hope you don't either, but at any rate, it's none of your business, excuse me.
Hey, wait a minute. I went to a lot of trouble to get you on staff at this hospital. The least you can do is give me a couple of minutes of your time. You see, I'm a little bit concerned as to what happens once the word gets around that this young and upcoming doctor is seeing a nurse that's almost twice his age.
Wait a minute. Now, you did the same thing with the same nurse, I mean, how many years ago?
Oh, come on, Casey, there's a little bit of difference there. We're just about the same age.
Well, frankly, I don't think you're in any position to tell Lila or me how to run our lives, okay?
All right, take it easy. There's no need for the cafeteria to know everything that's going on.
Well, I don't care who knows it. Now, if you're trying to turn this into something dirty, I'm not going to stand for it. Because you don't understand something. Lila and I are in love.
But just you remember this. I'm not going to stand by and let her be hurt when you decide to run off with somebody that's your own age.
I hope you didn't go on like this in front of her. Because she's already very sensitive about
this. Of course, and that ought to tell you just how long this thing is going to last.
Well, I'll tell you how long it's going to last. It'll last as long as we want it to. Now,
wait a minute. I'm not finished.
Get out of here. Wait, don't you go after him. I think you and I better have a little talk. All right, she's sleeping on right now. Sit. And I want you to listen, and I want you to listen good. I just came from seeing Mama.
Oh.
Tell me about your little visit. She's pretty hurt by some of the things you said, John.
She's not nearly as hurt as she's going to be if she keeps up this silly affair with Casey Peretti.
woman needs us in her life right now.
She does not need to be fooling around with a kid who is just out of med school.
Oh.
And I'm surprised that you and Tom cannot see that, that you condone it.
Casey is not a kid. What difference does his age make as long as he makes her happy?
I can't help feeling the way I do about your mother. I care about her. I don't want to
Yeah,
hurt
yeah,
Margo.
I know. Craig gave me the same line. I'll tell you exactly what I told him. Chances of happiness come along too far and few between to let them slip away without... slip away because you're thinking about what other people are thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Casey and Mama aren't hurting anybody. They're just in love the way you say you and Emma are.
Now, wait a minute. That's very, very
it's
different.
It's not different at
it,
all.
It
is not different. If you won't do it for Mama's sake, then why don't you do it for mine, all right? I want Mama to have this chance. And if you don't realize how important it is for Mama to have this chance, then I feel very, very sorry for you.
You don't understand.
I think I do. What is it? What's the matter? John? Sure.
Excuse me, John. May I have a word with you?
I'm real busy right now, Hal.
Well, at least you could introduce me to your lovely companion.
Right, this is Detective Margot Hughes.
I'm also his daughter.
How do you do? My name is Howard Lansing.
I know what your name is. Remember, I'm in the police.
Well, I'll catch you later sometime.
Right, okay.
Excuse me.
Nice to meet you. What on earth is your connection?
I have
with
no connection with that
fresh
man
out of
at all. He used to be an administrator in this hospital when I first started out. That's the connection, period. That's it.
A little defensive, John?
I'm not defensive. I'm upset. Upset about your mother and Casey Peretti. I got patients I've got to look after. I'll just say one other thing to you. When you and Tom can learn to be honest with yourselves, then maybe you can go around and give advice to other people.
Well, Brian was here, but he went to pick Beatrice up.
Oh, no. Well, we've been looking all over town. We've been trying to track her down.
Why? What's up?
Shannon called.
Yeah.
Where is she?
No, she wouldn't say, but she just wanted us to let Brian know that she was all right.
Yeah, we did our best to try to talk her into police coming home, and she wouldn't even hear of it. And it's just, I feel like if she and Brian could just get together, they could sit down, they could work this whole thing out, because, Tom, they love each other so much, too much to let something silly like this come between them.
Mom, just because two people are in love does not guarantee them happiness.
Really? My, aren't we cynical? Man, use your phone, darling. I'd like
sure.
to call Castle. Hey, Brian,
you want some coffee, Earl?
Tom, no thank you. Any news on that ledger page that I found?
Well, I gave it to Margo and I kept your name out of it.
Yeah.
I don't think there's a whole lot more you can do right now.
No, Julia, that's all right. No message. Thank you. Well, Brian's not there, neither is Beatrice. I guess we'll just have to wait until later.
Mom?
What?
Why don't you just leave it be?
No, I'm not going to do that. In fact, as soon as Shannon calls us again, I'm going to insist that she talk with Brian.
Mom, I really think you should let these two adult people handle this on their own.
Oh, no, I don't agree with you at all. No, I don't, because that's exactly what I did with you and Margo. I backed off when you were having your problem. Tom, I really feel like this must be said. Sweetheart, I saw the look on your face the night that you and Margo lost the baby.
Mom,
and I know how you both feel about this. But Tom, you have not talked it over with each other. You haven't been honest with one another, and that's not helping.
Mom, it's over. Now, we've buried it. Why can't you?
Tom, no, because you cannot bury something like this. You cannot bury someone without mourning them.
Are you sure there's no way to lock these things?
Not really. Besides, most every room in the castle has one. All of the passageways lead down to the tunnels and eventually to the docks.
I really wish you'd consider staying in Oakdale for a few days. Lisa's house is empty. I'm sure she wouldn't mind if you stayed there.
No, Brian. But thank you anyway.
What's the matter? You've been very quiet ever since you talked to Julia.
Harriet called. She didn't say where she was or even if she was with Shannon. Just that she called back.
Every time I see that look in your eyes, it hurts me so.
No, it's all right. I'm all right. It was Shannon's decision. I just have to accept the fact that she chose to leave. Not an easy thing to do, but I'll be all right.
I'm really rather tired. Would you mind if I say goodbye?
Of course not. Please call me if you need anything.
I will.
It's an authentic Scottish coin, all right.
I can offer you, say, $3,000 or $4,000 for it.
$4,000. I happen to know this is worth at least five times that.
Well, if somebody offered you that for it, I'd suggest you take it. But I can't imagine why anyone would want to pay that much.
What I want to know is how on earth is a struggling young doctor come into possession of something as rare and valuable as a Scottish ruckle?
Look, Neil, everything's going fine here. I just don't need any problems in Edinburgh.
Some fella named Munson came snooping around the records, but they were clean as a whistle.
Good. I have, another problem for you. McKechnie. Everything was going perfect until he decided he had a personal score to settle with me. He's involved with my ex-wife.
Well, there's not much I can do about that from here in Edinburgh.
Yeah, well, it turns out he's on his way over there. And I've got this feeling that he's going to be looking through Thomas Beaton's personal effects.
What happens if he starts getting too close?
Well, I'll just leave that up to you, Mr. McNeil.
Come on, Mr. Shannon. Shannon, don't you think it's a little bit late for a social visit?
No, Harriet, every light is on the building. There's bound to be somebody up.
Oh, that doesn't make it any less menacing. It's huge. Come on, let's go back in the morning.
No, we're already here. Come on.
Nobody home. Let's go.
No, Harriet, I think I hear somebody coming.
What are you doing here?
Well, I was just about to ask you the same question.
Come on in.
It is after six. It is past quitting time.
Hi.
Hi.
How was your day?
Unbearably hectic. Was yours?
It was.
Look, what say we go down to the health club? We get a nice long hot sauna. And then we go to Mona Lisa's for dinner. How's that sound?
Like a great idea.
Yay. All right. Let's go.
But first, I have to talk to you about something.
Sounds serious. We have to talk about it. I'm not sure I want to hear it.
Come here.
What are we going to propose again?
Sit down. Joe Bailey offered me a job. He wants me to head up a national task force on organized crime in conjunction with federal agencies.
Wow. Here?
No. In Washington, I'd have to take a leave of absence as DA.
What did you say to him?
That I'd have to talk to you first.
You want to do it, don't you?
Yeah. But only if it's okay with you. I figure it'd be something like last fall when you were in Washington. We hop on planes, go back and forth, see each other on the weekends, you know?
Sure. Sure, we could do that.
Sure. You don't want me to do this.
I didn't say that.
I know you didn't.
Did I say that?
No, you didn't say it.
Yeah, I didn't say that.
But
would you have considered this job offer if I hadn't lost the baby? you going home? I thought you had to work tonight.
I got somebody to switch with me at the last minute.
You talked to John, didn't you?
Yeah. I did. Well, I need to get home to talk to you. You okay?
I've been doing a lot of thinking today. And, having to face up to a lot of things, you know. Maybe Craig and John are right.
I was afraid of that.
Well, they're just concerned about me.
I know. I just thought maybe you could hold off having them find out until you, you know, felt a little more secure.
I don't think that would have mattered. I've just been suppressing everything. You know, just hiding all the problems, all the doubts. Maybe they're right, you know? I've been doing all this stuff out of sheer need.
No, honey, it's more than that. Come on, you've been happy with me.
I know, I've been very happy. Maybe I don't have a right to be that happy.
No, that's crazy.
No.
Well, who's stolen out the happiness in this town, John and Craig?
I just don't understand. You know, I've got all these feelings coming back again, all those doubts, I just can't handle it now.
I love you very much. I don't want to make you crazy. I'm not going to do that. If you have that many doubts, maybe we should just stop before it gets too late. You know how I feel. So, it's really up to you.
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you by Safeguard, the combination of maximum deodorant soap protection and a rich, thick lather. And by Ivory Liquid. Your hands can feel soft, smooth, doing dishes the ivory way. Stay tuned for Capital, next on most of these CBS stations.